You need to water that.
You want to talk to me about my plants?
Howard told me you wanted it back in. Obviously, that can't happen.
Says who?
You know, the law. You must be obsessing right now, and I get it.
You think I have a reason?
Maybe you do this time.
This time, as opposed to all the other times when I was just going cowboy, or was it flexing my ego playing cop?
So you do listen.
A little bit.
Michael, you got shot.
Already a beautiful relationship.
This is my team, my crew, my heart and soul. Michael, you know how hard I worked to build this. So you're gonna be in my arena, so you're gonna play by my rules, yes?
Absolutely. Because, you know, I can relate to hard work too, you know, recovering from 3 gunshot wounds.
Oh, no, just stop. You know that's not what I meant. The fact that you're here shows you don't trust me.
Rita, in these streets, I never trusted anybody but Marcus. Come on, just don't take that personal.
Well, Mark isn't here anymore.
Easy. The white button, Mike.
I got it. Relax.
Simple is right there.
I got it.
Damn.
Hey. Mike, I thought you didn't have any interest in having children.
Nah, that ain't mine. How you doing?
Charisse.
Yeah. Girl, you had to tell me that from the thing with what you call me now. I didn't know you worked here.
I swear we met.
Hey, all right, Charisse, look, I'm having a day here. Look, I got shot, and there's an informant that I have to get to, and my partner's driving slow as a fuck. Can you tell me what room the brunette girls are in?
Let's see, 2 doors to the left, but you can't. Nice minivan.
Not mine. Unmarked Yamaha M109. Yeah. I need you to get that out for me immediately, all right?
Hey, Howard wants to talk to you.
Yeah, tell him I'll call him.
Said he'll call you.
You know, Mike ain't gonna make it out here. Something shook loose in him.
I know. It's worse than ever. I didn't think that was possible.
Marcus! Tuck ass! Bring it! Tuck ass!
I'm sorry, Rita, but I gotta go.
You're always fucking with my evidence. This isn't a goddamn valet parking, you know, you guys. Come on, you guys know better than this.
My bad.
Baby, I am so sorry.
If he had driven Marcus, any faster.
We will talk about this when we get home.
All right, I'm gonna let you off right here.
Mike, he's not gonna stop until you stop. So please, finish this.
Five yards.
Where you at there, man?
You're clear in 3, 2, 1. Clear.
Ma. Estoy listo.
Ayúdame.
Ve que estás.
Gracias.
Mamá, ¿quién es?
No te preocupes. Todo esto va a terminar esta noche.
Stand down. Stand down. Hey, stand down.
Look at me. That's enough. No more blood.
Hey, Mark.
Engage.
I'm gonna wait for that helicopter because I'm not gonna loop this whole scene.
Wait, time out. I have no idea what the blocking is. Wait.
He's dying. My pinky.
Michael.
Are you fucking kidding me?
I'm looking for you.
Here.
Oh, fuck. I don't have the...
Oh, God damn it, Joey! It's on my foot.
Sorry.
I'm like, it's on my foot.
I'm
it's
so
on my
sorry.
Foot.
And I
needed
to.
No, yeah, no.
I'm so sorry.
I lost all my Mike Lowry. I was like, Joey.
No. Sorry, excuse me.
Marcus, as soon as you identify the shooter, we'll engage from the perimeter.
Marcus, as soon as you identify the shooter, we'll engage from the perimeter. Stop! Perimeter.
Fuck. Y'all will never do that again.
Marcus, as soon as you identify the shooter, we'll engage from the perimeter. No, I have to.
I'm just trying to see if I'm tripping. If you was gonna fuck a witch, would you use a condom?
Right. Right.
Here we go.
Did y'all win at least?
Hell no. He was a star player. Went for 40, but hell no. Ah, shit. Hell no. He was our star player. We lost by 40. But hey, I made my point. There's no team. There's no I in team.
Yeah. Can we go?
My big guy gets a muffin.
It's her baby. Sorry, getting tired, getting old. All right.
Whatever you need, get us to the fucking hotel.
Being a bad boy, it's like we willing to do whatever we gotta do to keep them streets clean.
Having Will and Martin come back to do this movie is just iconic.
The cars, the flash, the locations weaved with action sequences and the comedy. It's a very hard thing to do.
It's the magic of chemistry.
They are the baddest guys in the room.
From the very first costume test, it was like the bad boys were back.
It's got great stunts, terrific action, and two characters you love.
This is at the point in their lives where they say, are we gonna really ride together or die together?
We ride this thing till the wheels fall off. Bad boys for life.
Getting to a part three, mm-hmm. Were you concerned that there wasn't gonna be more story to tell?
I was concerned that it wasn't gonna happen.
Yeah.
You know, I was waiting for it so long.
Yeah.
And I just wanted to get back with you again to do it. And time kept going and you called me.
Those two movies, Michael Bay really created a whole world where you have a feeling that there are much more stories to be told.
Just relax. Oh!
As fans, we were just waiting to see more of that world, and it is a continuation of what he established.
B-Mark!
And out!
We started pushing Sony about 2 or 3 years after Bad Boys 2 came out to start developing a new one. I got a phone call from Will, and he was on the Great Wall of China shooting The Karate Kid with Jaden. That was 2009, and he pitched a scene where he and Martin break up, and it's basically word for word what we shot. A couple weeks ago.
You need to start thinking about your karma, man. This was a sign.
A sign, yeah, a sign to turn up. So I'm supposed to bow down now, get this bitch a pass?
Turn up? What are you, 20? I want to retire and kind of settle and family life and all that. And I don't know how much Mike is growing.
Are you even healed?
Yeah, I'm fine.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Rita. You sure? You're fine.
Rita,
you're fine.
Stop.
We had all sorts of crazy ideas, a lot of different writers working on it. It wasn't until about exactly 2 years ago when Chris Bremner came onto it.
When I saw Bad Boys 1, I was 12, and I rented it with my mom at Blockbuster, right?
Chris's tremendous accomplishment was rework what was there and just make everything better.
I really just tried to put myself in the minds of Mike Lowry and Marcus Burnett, you know, 15 years later in Bad Boys movie world time.
We fly together, we die together.
What?
Oh, no. That's just something we say.
There were two story points in this one that I was like, okay, now we got a new movie to make. And the one was the opening sequence.
Action.
With your character becoming a grandfather.
Grandpa.
Like, that's new territory. Mm-hmm. And then my character, Mike, getting shot.
When I read it, I was emotional. I didn't expect to be a Bad Boys movie to be emotional. And seeing the Bad Boys breaking up, that was like, oh shit, is this really happening? And what is going to happen now? And it was really interesting to see that.
And that's gonna push Mike Lowry into this journey where he discovered, you know, himself.
He's right there, Rita. We can grab him.
No, I'm not risking the collateral damage. Let's wait.
You're the boss.
Yeah, I know.
That's what I just said.
Yeah, I just confirmed it.
What were the things that you felt were the most important things to not lose from 1 and 2 coming into 3?
The comedy.
Comedy for sure.
Comedy for sure.
Sorry, rich white people.
We're not just black, we're cops too.
There's been like a little bit of an old married couple kind of vibe.
Yeah, yeah.
That we had. And to me, that was the one thing. It's like that, the odd couple vibe.
Right.
I cannot even describe it. When they're both together, boom, something magic happens.
Something, and whatever they do is funny and it's cool and it's so interesting. You don't have to do a lot as a director.
No, it's just, it's there.
Let them do.
It's a pleasure.
And cut, let's go on board.
They're so good together. They're so funny and they do it so effortlessly. Their chemistry is just unreal.
That better be a safe or a piano.
Oh, this is my wife's car.
It's hard not to crack up when you're watching Will and Martin in a scene. They're really funny.
Those differences are so ripe for comedy, so ripe for drama, so ripe for conflict.
The yin and the yang.
The yin and the yang, absolutely.
Generally, Will Smith is the coolest guy in the room.
Nigga, I don't tell you all my business.
He is sort of the wise ass, right? He's the one that sort of always has the quip. And what's so wonderful is Martin, with this sort of unassuming energy, manages to always actually be the one that gets at Mike Lowry.
She just wasn't the one for me. Right?
What is for you, Mike? Dying all alone and sad as shit?
Will would talk about this. Martin just has an incredible ability to, yeah, make fun of Will in a way that really works. And that's rare.
Bad Boys of the Bible, baby.
Exactly.
Amen.
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 I think it's more about the relationship between Will and Martin than it is about Mike and Marcus. I truly believe that when the actors are having a good time, the audience can pick up on it.
I mean, you could, if you wanted to, just do the speed limit. You let a Prius pass us.
One and Two had great humor, had great action. Michael Bay created the style of the first two movies, and we're very fortunate. We found two directors who were from Belgium. They're Moroccans.
So I'm Adil, and I am Bilal, and we're the directors from Bad Boys
for Life.
And we just
and they made a movie that we loved called Black. It was very dark, but they'd made it for very little money, and there were only a few professional actors, and they did an amazing job. And they have such an infectious personality, these two individuals, and Adil and Bilal.
Day 17.
Woo! Yeah.
Party!
Party!
The way we're formed as movie makers, I think that Jerry has a lot of influence on how we make movies.
Yeah.
So thank you, Jerry, for inspiring us and to work with us. It's crazy.
And they are warm and funny and get the set excited about what we're doing.
Welcome to the set. We're at Ocean Drive. Neons.
These two guys add a great legacy to the franchise.
Well, right now we are on the set of the ammo headquarters, which is the place where the young new squad, the Captain Howard and his colleague Rita, who is also the ex of Mike Lowry, created.
Rated strictly non-lethal.
To have a new kind of investigative team to solve crimes.
The movie's set in Miami, and we're shooting you know, a good chunk of it in Atlanta.
And so we really worked on trying to find the right locations to kind of give the Miami flavor of the movie, even though we weren't there.
John Billington, as our production designer, came in and has done a really good job of helping us make Atlanta look like Miami.
Well, it's really colorful. It has a lot of this exotic flavor, this, because if you go to Miami, it's not really the States. It's really a blend of different cultures and all those aspects of all those cultures that makes it so exotic. And we try to put that in the movie and in the colors and in everything we do.
So I'm here with cameraman Robrecht Havaert, who doesn't like to be filmed, really concentrated. And he just doesn't give a fuck. The genius.
Adil and Bilal have worked with our director of photography on their other films, Robrecht Havaert, and they really wanted Rob to come shoot this film. Believe it or not, in 15 years, technology's changed a little bit, so he's got access to a lot of toys and cranes and things of that nature that allow him to move the camera in a really dynamic way and sort of maintain the feel that Michael created, which is creating a really energetic, exciting, fun brand.
Doing a massive motorcycle chase through downtown Atlanta was a huge logistical puzzle. And we were very fortunate because we had the city and all the locations were really super helpful. The State Film Commission and the city film commissioners and all the people that work here in Atlanta really helped to make that happen.
The audience wants to see a big action sequence like the first two Bad Boys movies, and obviously the second one had this massive, massive chase scene on the highway, which was never done before. So you want to have something that, you know, reminds you or pays homage to that scene. At the same time, we want to put our own flavor to it. So it's all at night, it's very colorful, it's very kinetic, and it's not a clean action scene. It's like a funky, stylized, crazy, raw action sequence.
Yeah, now that, you know, that's gonna be one of the signature scenes of this movie, that yeah. Motorcycle chase. Yeah.
Mike Lowry's style, I feel, is also so iconic. He always looks like such a badass in high fashion clothes.
We started this movie for Mike Lowry in bright and fun and colorful, because bam, the first time you see them in that car, he's in a bright orange, super fun. He's got glasses that match. It's everything, right? And the second time you see him, he's in yellow. Like, he's colorful, he's Miami, then he gets shot. So then from there, it's dark. His clothes are a reflection of how he's feeling, which is dark. He has a really good eye. He knows what he likes, he knows what he doesn't like, but he really lets you do your job and embraces your vision and then adds his own to it, which is the perfect collaborator. Dressing Martin was amazing. He looks great also. He's in great shape, he looks wonderful. It wasn't like we had to do anything differently. It was just like, okay, what would he wear today? So the ammo team goes undercover at Zillion's Club. So if they were dressing for a nightclub, what would they dress like? What do they have in their closet? Did they have it in their closet? Or did they have to go someplace to get it? Like, Kelly is a bottle girl. She's wearing a crazy little like bikini thing with boots, super fun. Rita's in a super sexy dress. Rafe is with a shirt with the sleeves cut off. So it was like them dressed as if they were going to a crazy nightclub.
I can't tonight.
This is going to be the look. All Versace. Woo! First time in my life. All by this woman right here. Thank you, Dana.
So Armando, we made this moto suit for, and he's wearing it most of the movie. It's the suit that he wears on the motorcycle, and when he's killing people, he's wearing it. But there's also snakes on the back of it. That came out really good.
Oh, yeah! We're the Bad Boys of cinema, yeah. You know? Is this breaking the rule?
That's why we relate so much to those characters. I mean, they're good cops, but they don't follow the rules. They bend the rules, they have their own style, and that's a little bit how we see ourselves, I think.
Yeah.
Right?
I'm putting your seatbelt on, huh?
Yeah.
That's how
yeah,
we do it now.
Right.
There's such a deep love for these characters and for this franchise. It's great to come to work every day with
guys. It really is. It really is.
We said for life. For life, baby.
I think it's 25 years.
Whoa!
It's in the 90s.
I love you, man. Fuck you, Marcus.
People want to see them more than ever.
I love those movies, and I watched them as a kid.
Big fan of Will Smith and Martin Lawrence.
This movie is bigger than a movie. It's part of the culture.
Can you not get a better car than that? Don't be coming at me with that tone, Mike.
Freak.
Those two movies, Michael Bay really created a whole world.
Let's finish strong.
Jerry Bruckheimer took a long shot on, you know, two young black dudes that had TV shows, and he put that Jerry Bruckheimer sauce on it and gave us the first Bad Boys, Jerry Bruckheimer.
Well, we had an idea that we loved, and we kept developing that idea, and we had to figure out who could we cast.
You know, there was a screenplay, but it wasn't like, right. It was for Dana Carvey and John Lovitz.
Right.
John Lovitz and Dana Carvey were the first two. So we did a test with them, and they didn't like the two of them together.
Hey, baby!
So I think an agent called me and said, you really should meet this guy, Will Smith. He was on Fresh Prince at the time, and I think he'd done one small movie. And I came in my office, and this guy's tall, he's handsome, he's funny, he's got an infectious personality. And I said, he's the guy. And then Martin had a TV show that was doing quite well. And I think the management at Sony really liked him a lot. And so we put the two of them together.
You know, you drive almost slow enough to drive Miss Daisy.
We're fortunate to have the two of them. And because they're both, I guess, icons on television right now, and we're gonna make them movie stars.
You know, Jerry and Don were some of the first to do this tone where it's very real but also very funny at the same time.
Don't be alarmed, we're Negroes.
If they didn't invent this genre, they were there at the beginning of the buddy cop action movie. And this movie in particular, I think, was pretty groundbreaking in that it starred two African-American characters.
When the first Bad Boys came out, Martin and Will had just both come off of television series. Amazing hit television series. So to see the two of them doing something completely different and their chemistry being so unique.
Bitch!
You freeze, bitch.
Oh, shit.
Put the gun down and give me a pack of Tropical Fruit Bubblicious. And some Skittles.
I believe that that's what sort of shocked people, because the chemistry, the shows were so different. Yet together with this Bad Boys franchise, they all of a sudden created something that everybody wanted to watch, have fun with, and look forward to the next.
Woo! Looks like we got us a situation here.
You ain't gonna shoot, nigga.
See, what you don't understand is my partner came here tonight prepared to die. Hell no!
I mean, the first movie, I mean, there's so many scenes, like the ending scene and the scene with the car, you know,
yeah.
Where he says, that's how you're supposed to drive. That whole action sequence is fantastic.
Now that's how you're supposed to drive.
The second movie, you have the Reggie moment.
The Reggie. Yeah,
yeah. You look like dirty motherfuckers.
Yeah.
Who the fuck are you?
I'm Mr. Bennett. I'm Reggie.
How old are you?
I'm 15, Mr. Bennett.
Motherfucker, you look 30.
We have Reggie in the movie, so he's coming back.
Reggie. I am shocked that you are even still here.
Yeah, Reggie, I mean, everything that we love, also the real daughter is Bianca that plays the daughter, Megan, which also, we wanted them two back again.
Yeah, absolutely the same cast.
You want me to take Megan out?
Yes, sir.
How old is you?
15.
Shit, nigga, you at least 30.
Welcome to our nightmare, boys.
I think it's 25 years since the first Bad Boys. And the relationship between Martin and Will, I think that's the franchise.
Don't ever say I wasn't there for you.
In Bad Boys 1, they said, Will, we need you to throw a phone. He didn't just throw the phone. He,
son of a bitch!
He wanted to break something. And then in Bad Boys 3, he got to kick a door open. He don't just kick the door open, he kicks it off the hinges.
Yeah, knock, knock. What happened to knock and talk?
Oh, and I know in 2, when they go to the captain's house, and Marcus is taking the ecstasy. That's
yeah. Evening, Captain.
Hello. Captain.
That was excellent.
They've really found this great blend between dark comedy, amazing action, and these really heartfelt moments that really speak to the audience.
I still, to this day, watch 1 and 2 because there's always something. I'm always laughing at different parts now, and I can actually find parts that I don't ever remember hearing before.
So yeah, why don't you rent a movie or something?
Bad Boys, the second one in particular, is one of those movies that every time it's on the TV and I'm doing something, I would sit down, watch it, and laugh again and again.
Oh, this is that bullshit!
I think funny is money, and anytime you make something that an audience can laugh, you know, life can get tough sometimes, and you need relief. And hopefully going to see Bad Boys, you get enormous relief, because it's action-packed, it's got great stunts, great characters, terrific action. You're on a great ride with them.
Mike and I, we're going on 25 years of working these streets. And I like to think we made a difference. You all are the best. And I thank you.
Knock and talk.
Knock, knock.
The old school Bad Boys versus ammo and new style policing.
What the hell are y'all doing here?
The old heads that know how to get it done, kicking right. Doors. But the young boys are saying,
there's a little bit easier way, guys. This here is the remix, Mike. We work with ammo now.
Not fooling around in here.
We're having fun, man. Making this movie is gonna be the bomb. Next level shit.
Everybody ready?
Yeah.
I've grown to the point where I'm gonna retire and kind of settle and.
Martin is genius.
Daddy is.
Because every time he opens his mouth, he's like, he's holding the baby. And he was playing, he's like.
Marcus.
Marcus looking the baby.
Not to blow smoke up you, but you like, there's a comedy genius that you have.
Well, thank you.
That's why we have chemistry. Because you say stuff like that. Will, when he dives in and he says he has something he wants to accomplish, I mean, I don't know if I've seen anybody do it better, man.
Thank you, man.
I cannot even describe it. When they're both together, boom, something magic happens.
Oh, shit! There's a fucking dog! Get on! You wanna get bit, you wanna get shot?
Whatever they do is fucking funny and it's cool and it's so interesting.
You just put the camera on it and you get money right away.
Now, I'm gonna penetrate this man's soul with my heart.
What?
Watch and learn.
What did I say? He's gonna investigate this case no matter what!
Captain Howard is just awesome. He's the man. I mean, he's one of the most iconic police chiefs ever.
God damn it! What did I tell you?
Yeah, it's like you wouldn't have Bad Boys without Captain Howard.
No.
He is just such a character. Hearing his voice, you know that it's him. He's so unique.
Oh, so he got anybody?
Well, that's a relief.
You know, you just want to see him yell at the bad boys or at Mike Lowry, and it's just exhilarating to see him perform like that.
The last one was a 10. Do you want this to be like a 7 or a 6?
7.72.
7.7. Right. I was scared, to tell you the truth. But then as soon as they said action, it's like, I guess it's like riding a bike.
Fuck me!
Ammo team is fresh, they're young.
They help Grant?
They do things the way the textbook is written.
This raid is strictly non-lethal.
Rita's ahead of ammo. This is her baby.
What's up, fellas?
She handpicked every person from the ammo team.
Hola.
Rita just felt so part of who I am.
She also has had a past relationship with Mike, which makes things sticky.
That's why.
You're the boss.
Yeah, I know.
That's what I just said.
Yeah, I just confirmed it.
Okay.
They care about each other, but at the same time,
still have the key.
Professionally, they really clash.
You think you could stop calling me Michael in front of everybody?
It's your name.
Rafe is like the mouth.
When I see Suelo running, I just get out of the car like a badass. What I do.
I like to say our token asshole.
When you're an actor, you're paid to do that shit.
Paid to do this.
He's got a big, strong head on his shoulders. There's a little clash between him and Will Smith, in a sense.
Spam me the street knowledge, Grandpa.
Pretty intense scene.
I will knock your bitch ass clean up.
Knock me out. Hit me.
What am I, a nursery school teacher? You come know. On, let's go.
As an actor, it was very surreal.
Kelly, she's a badass. She's fearless.
Miami PD, freeze.
Vanessa's character, Kelly, is the weapon specialist.
So my cop school was at a shooting range.
ACLU rounds, rubber. Trust me, you'll enjoy them. You get to shoot as much as you want.
And I have worked with guns before. So I felt like I had a slight upper hand.
Jeez. They just leave you in the van.
Yeah, I'm more comfortable here.
Dorn is kind of like the brains of the group.
The biggest guy on the team, you think he's the muscle, but he's kind of the opposite.
Just in the way, constantly. I don't belong here.
No,
he's really just a big teddy bear.
Excuse me, we're doing some serious detective work here right now. Right?
There's a reason that each and every person in the ammo team were chosen, and if they can all work together, it can be a pretty special team.
Big man, I'm gonna need you to hurt some people. I'll pay for the therapy, all right?
I'm gonna need it, seriously.
Mike and Marcus learned from the ammo group that there is another way to do things, and...
You called them again.
They really called me.
I think the ammo unit from Mike and Marcus learned what it is to be a bad boy, in a sense, you know? Kind of get your hands dirty and do what's right when it comes down to it.
I feel better when they're here.
Yeah, me too.
Go fuck yourself!
Isabella, there's a reason why she does this payback. You know, we didn't want to have a villain that is just evil. She has a good reason that anybody could understand. And we wanted to have somebody that is dangerous but also attractive. She's La Bruja, she's the witch. And all these elements, we thought it would be really interesting for a villain like that.
Actually, I am the good girl. He's a bad one because he betrayed me. He betrayed me and he put me in jail.
The coward, the traitor, y el hijo de puta que nos destruyó.
I wanted her to be a real woman who's been hurt, who's been betrayed, and who's a mom, you know, and that's the greatest love a woman can have.
Mama.
Mijo.
Armando is a complicated character.
Oh,
He's my little boy, you know, and Mexican moms, we don't care if he's 30 or 40 or 20, he will never get out of my side.
If you thought Oedipus was complicated, then you ain't seen shit yet.
No entiendo, mamá.
Una bala es misericordia para ese hijo de puta que te quitó a tu papá.
He's just a killer machine, but he's also somebody with a lot of emotion and a lot of depths.
Just them two in a room until he was 6 years old, so the bond that they created together was, you know, incomparable. And then he was torn away from her at the age of 6. His mom loves him, there's no doubt about that, but it's a tainted love.
Cierto lo que dice.
No importa, no significa nada para ti.
Because she did some bad things and she wants revenge so much and she has this pact with La Santa Muerte is paying her back. Mike wins and she has nothing. I'm telling you, I'm feeling for her. She's the good, good guy of the movie.
Top of the world, baby!
This beautiful face over here.
Mandalos. Yeah. Suelo.
So I play Suelo. Suelo is like upscale gangster. You know what I'm saying? Like, he's not in the corner anymore. He has his whole crew. But he is still Suelo. He's still crazy. He's still from the hood. When they shoot me with the rubber bullet, the lump looks like solder form. I look like a unicorn.
Oh, shit. Oh, look at that. Damn. Oh, that is some Elephant Man shit right there.
You see a Marcus, like, I gotta touch it. Touches the lump, like, oh. It was so hard for me to do that part because I wanted to laugh. But I gotta act like I'm knocked out. Right there, that's gonna be a legend part.
Oh shit, Mike Larry.
The guys, Dylan Bilal, their first thought for Manny the Butcher was always DJ Khaled.
No! My pinky!
Doing a scene with Will Smith, the icon. And let me tell you something. Not only history being made, I'm in it.
I'm trending worldwide.
I filmed earlier.
I don't even want to call it acting because we in here really doing some real life things in here. And I realized I was, you know, in a scene and I locked eyes with Will Smith. And I said, what the fuck?
Oh shit, Mike Lowry, you a ghost or something? Motherfucker, you know they say you're dead, fuck boy.
That was good.
And trended worldwide.
And cut. Okay, let's reset.
Motherfucking Khaled and Will Smith. Man, that's crazy. I know what I gotta do. I gotta take a pause when you walk in shocked.
Yeah.
To make it all connect.
What are you doing here?
Yeah, that's the word. What are you doing here?
Yeah.
Mike Larry, what are you doing here?
You're confused.
You look like a ghost. Yeah. Then go into that.
Oh shit, Mike Larry, what are you doing here?
And that's to go around, on that line, all right?
What do you mean, go
that when you go around? Okay. All right. All right. So all these vegans in Miami, and you want me to believe that that hot ride outside came from selling pork chops?
I'm a hardworking man, man. I'm a family man. I work at Manny's, man. Honest living.
Oh.
Yeah.
Did you put pig fat on my suit?
Shout out to the great directors and of course Will Smith for not only believing in me, but also coaching me.
DJ so Khaled for life.
Will Smith, Martin Lawrence, bless up.
We believe that it just makes it much more exciting when the villain is real and when the danger is real.
You got a fucked up family, Mike.
Yo, what's up? I'm Adele.
And I'm Bilal.
So we're the directors of Bad Boys for Life.
Very good, thank you.
That's that shit right there.
Yeah, we're making a movie and making the making of.
Yeah, I've been making a movie.
Peace.
Peace.
Next level shit.
Damn.
Peace.
Got it.
Woo, great shot.
Adil and Bilal.
Oh, oh yeah.
They come with a lot of love every day. Yes. They hug everybody.
Yeah.
Keep on rolling. Awesome. Awesome. Very good. Very good.
Going right to the set.
You gotta get in there, man.
You gotta get in there.
Yo, fall off.
Yeah. Welcome to the set.
They had done sort of Romeo and Juliet style action movie called Black. And it was just so dynamic and energetic and original. When I saw that film, it was like, these guys really have it.
Cut.
Just have them a little bit more backwards.
So they bring their kind of gritty street way of making a movie to a big franchise. And so it's a fresh approach. It's really different.
And action!
Now.
The fanboys, actually.
Yeah, yeah, we're like the most luckiest fanboys ever.
Beautiful shot.
All right, good.
Next level shot.
They're coming at Bad Boys from a different angle. They're coming at it from fans.
Next level. They always say next level shit.
Yeah.
Next level shit.
Next level shit.
Next level shit, brother.
B&B Flavor Flav.
Things to look raw, they love it to look cutting edge, they want it to be exciting and feel really gritty, so there's this realistic element that goes along with this heightened world of the Bad Boys. They're keeping it really exciting.
No, time is always the enemy. Still got, I think, 2 hours to finish two scenes, so fuck! Part of the job, man.
The first two movies, they're honoring that, but they're 100% doing their own thing with it.
The bar is pretty high. It's trying to make super exciting action, but at the same time, getting something kinetic and gritty and real and raw.
Okay, last one, and give everything, everybody.
They know how to shoot sexy movies.
Fantastic.
You shoot, and then you move.
Boom, boom, and then action.
They have incredible visual eye, and they shoot everything with three cameras, and the cameras are always moving, and so you really have to be on your toes.
Three cameras, because it's Bad Boys 3.
It's such a deep love for these characters and for this franchise. It's great to come to work every day with
It really is. It really is.
So yeah, we sprinkled some A&B flavor in the movie. That's what we did.
It's a mix of Michael Bay and A&B.
We did that shit.
Peace.
Rolling, rolling.
Hey, Mark.
What's really unique to me about Bad Boys is the action is real.
Action!
This movie was kind of a little bit of everything. Driving, fights, wire work, choreography, you cover the gamut.
So often, you know, you go on some movies and you don't get to do half of the stuff because they just do it digitally. And so it's been fun for us to be able to actually get our hands into it.
So Michael Bay is a genius. I mean, with hands down, he's unbelievably great at what he does. The first challenge is, hey, how are we gonna one up or outdo the first two? It is big shoes to fill.
How was it to work with Michael Bay?
Intense. It was this all day, every day, just like we're doing now, continuing it on.
You see that? They throw in cars. How have I not seen that?
Spent special effects and I kind of go hand in hand on every movie, right? We're kind of attached at the hip.
I build the gags, so I lean on them to put it through the paces.
I would say to him, hey, this is what I need. I need, you know, all these parameters for the car to keep my performer safe.
So you build it, they'd ride it around, see how it's gonna react.
Definitely a partnership for sure with him and I.
Because our directors wanted so much of this stuff real and in camera, my biggest concern was just how to get Will and Martin through all this stuff and doing it safely.
So it's a real challenge, but we're really going for that challenge.
Yeah, we made some stunt adjustments on this movie.
Yeah. It's a little hard on me. You know, I don't have, my back ain't the best back in the world, but we get the job done. Yeah, and we got good stuntmen.
Yeah, for sure.
And then if you got good stuntmen, why not use them?
Exactly.
The club is, you know, two stories and everything has to seem seamless. So first unit is obviously very based with the actors.
Jump now! She!
And then second unit obviously is majority of stunt performers that are portraying them. First unit now knows, hey, this is what we shot. This is what you guys shot.
One, drop.
So now you feel like, okay, now they're gonna merge together.
Jump now, she.
A lot of pieces that go into making an exciting stunt sequence.
They get out of the club, a big chase takes place. Everything has got to be safe for everyone. What's the shot we want? And what can I put our actor in to still make the audience feel like they've been in the whole shot, but part of it's going to be a double and part of it will be green screen work.
Hey, can you pull over for a second? I think Marcus needs to go potty.
Damn it, Mike.
And part of it will be our hero. And then you start to add elements to it. First, it's just the bike. Okay, cool, this is the path. Then you start to add a couple cars. You're like, okay, now we're gonna weave around these cars. Everyone's going, you know, the same speed. This is your route. You know, and as long as everyone stays on point, everyone goes home safe. No one's drinking out of a straw.
I've been driving motorcycles since I was like 8 years old.
I had motorcycle lessons with him. He was easy, he'd jump on a bike, no problem.
They didn't really use the stunt guy the way they should, because I did a couple of my things. I can't say I did all the stunts, because I'm not 20 years old anymore, you know, but I did pretty good.
We got here a stunt guy. What's your name, brother?
What's up, Dan.
Dan, and here we got real Mickey Jam.
I'm not supposed to show him. I want people to think it's me, man.
Stunt guys, he's like ready for action. They're ready for the real deal. So I love working with them.
They wanted the feel of like wheelie boys. So they wanted the guys that could 12 o'clock.
Really looked at some of the, you know, the world's best motorcyclists.
Were unbelievable. And the directors had this cool idea where they wanted them to like do circle wheelies around the car while our heroes were in the car. And then while the shootout's going on.
We got 250 squibs going off. In addition to that, trunnion guns inside, which shoots a projectile out. Most of the time it frags as it comes out the front window.
Right. And all our wheelie boys and our girl back here, you guys are just hammering.
And then finally, our heroes hijack a motorcycle with a sidecar. So now there's a gun battle, you know, on the live freeway.
I got this huge machine gun.
Oh, yeah!
I had fun. That wasn't bad. And I don't know how much Will loved it. Yeah, but
now that, you know, that's going to be one of the signature scenes of this movie. It's just so uniquely Bad Boys.
We did one scenario on a trailer that was safe and that we could tow them, and it was all limited. But then we also had to build one for stunts that they could free drive.
And in effects, they're blowing cars up. they're doing poppers. We have bikes going down.
The separation rig where we were able to separate Will so as a free drive bike. And then we took the little sidecar and we built a go-kart under it. So when they kicked apart, it dropped and it looked like it was skidding and we had sparks. And then the stunt guy could drive it like a little go-kart and he's ping-ponging off of cars. You know, this whole big flatbed trailer that's carrying propane explodes. Then a helicopter comes into play.
We up here right now.
You know how like when you swing in a swing too high, yeah, and you get that free fall feeling of, oh.
All right, guy, you got me, bro?
Yeah,
okay,
yeah,
okay.
Yeah.
Ooh.
I've never been in a helicopter, and I still haven't.
Moving, detective.
The finale sequence when, you know, we're dealing with, you know, 20 guys in this room, they're all getting shot.
Tons of explosions, and we dropped a whole staircase with stunt guys on it. We dropped a balcony with a stunt guy on it that had to write it down.
The directors wanted, like, fire, tons of gunfire with stunt players that are squibbed up that are getting shot.
Martin and Will take cover behind a table that they kind of roll, and it's taking fire.
Will and Martin were in every one of those shots. We basically just used doubles to map it out and rehearse, make sure camera was where it needs to be, and kind of back into it that way.
All right, so show the next part that we would.
And then once we had it perfect, then our heroes would run it once, okay, everyone's good, and then
two, three.
We would go hot, and then everything would be on.
Oh, shit!
You're reading through, and it's like helicopter crash, motorcycle crash, car flip, car explosion.
Oh!
You're just going, yeah, Michael Bay would be proud.
Yeah, I think he'd have his moments where he'd be like, yeah, good job.
I just love when, like, when you know that you're making a classic bad boy scene.
Oh, shit.
That's gonna be remembered for a long time.
It will be.
Ooh. Get me the fuck out of this car.
Yo, what's up? I'm Adil.
And I'm Bilal. What's up?
And we're the directors of Bad Boys for Life. Grew up on those two movies. We're big, big fans.
When I was on the playground, I was like one of the bad boys.
That's right. And we wanted this movie to be an homage to the movies by Michael Bay, the
Jerry Bruckheimer.
Yeah, so we dropped some Easter eggs here and there for the movie.
Yep.
Yeah, so check it out. The ammo van is like an important character in the movie.
Nah, that ain't the one. We're taking the crawdaddy. Wait until you see the inside.
The design of it, the layout, it's inspired by the trucks that you see in the first and the second movie.
And can you please drive this thing? Don't please drive. Don't bring it here. You don't want to pick up a slow-ass ice cream truck.
That's no match to the van.
Thank you, God.
Did you see that shit?
You absolutely wanted Michael Bay in a movie. You want to have a cameo. So we were like, yo, Michael Bay, you want to play a little small part in the movie? And he said yes.
Yeah, for us, it was really like also a callback to the second movie because he also has a cameo over there in the car.
Stop! We need your car, all right? Get out the car. Can you not get a better car than that?
But I was stressed out for that
day. Stressing.
I mean, what was the only lesson that he gave to you?
He said, don't fuck up my baby.
Yeah.
What we did is a Michael Bay shot around Michael Bay.
Yeah, so it's super meta.
It's
so,
like, he directed the shot himself.
Yeah, basically, you don't direct Michael Bay, he just directs himself.
Freak.
So, because Michael Bay had a cameo in the second movie and also in this one, we thought, hey, you know, let's do a little something ourselves.
Yeah.
That dress is incredible, girl. You got style.
He really has a part, you
know,
his dialogue.
Yeah, a little part where I'm like with Rita and I try to like seduce her.
I can't. I'm here with my girlfriends. They can come too, baby.
I can't tonight.
And in order to convince him to play that, I had to promise that I would also do something in the movie.
Yeah, I said, I'm not going to play if you're not going to play.
Yeah,
so then you got Will going to the lift car.
Yeah.
Grabs him by the hair.
Yeah, so I did that. I did that shit, even though I don't have a driver's license.
Back up!
Oh, there's a cool shot in the movie.
Yeah, it was like super important shot for us. It's in the beginning of the movie,
like a low angle,
low
slow
angle,
motion, which is like a typical
cool
Michael Bay shot.
Michael Bay all over, and then Marcus hits the fire hydrant when he opens the door.
Hey! Oh shit!
It's like you're, you know, trying to do like a little jokey joke with the Michael Bay shot, because when people come out of a car in his movies, it's always the coolest way of coming out of a car.
And Marcus always damages the car of Mike. So
like in the first one, he's like it's some fries, you know, they fall there. Second one, he shoots in the Ferrari.
Oh man, what are you doing, man?
And also, it's a reference to something that really happened on the set of Bad Boys 2, where Michael's real car was used, and he was super scared that it'd be damaged. And then at the end of the shooting day, Martin came out of the car and he dinked, you know, the car. So that's like a real life thing that we used in the movie.
Come on, man.
Marcus always fucks up the car, man.
Yeah.
You can get that buffed out.
No, you can get that buffed out. Oh, yeah!
So there's also a big Michael Bay homage. Tell us about that shot.
Yeah, it's the moment when Mike and Marcus stand up and we do like a 360 low angle around them in slow-mo. Typical Michael Bay first.
Bad Boys.
First, Bad Boys, you have that too when they're, you know, Mike is running after the bad guy.
And he saves Marcus.
Don't ever say I wasn't there for you.
It's in Miami also, and we shot that also in a like similar kind of neighborhood, and it's also after a fight. And also, you know, in the second movie, you have that moment, similar kind of moment, and the music track that we use on that shot is exactly the same theme, the same melody, Mark Mancina's soundtrack from the first movie.
Shit just got real.
One of our favorite scenes in Bad Boys 2 is, of course, the Reggie scene.
Who the fuck are you?
I'm Mr. Bennett. I'm Reggie.
And it's like an iconic scene from the movie.
You're taking Megan out. Yes, sir. How old is you? 15. Shit, nigga, you at least 30.
And for us, it was important to have real Reggie.
I am shocked that you are even still here.
and we were like searching for months to find him. And eventually found him. And
yeah, through social media. And it was also important that Megan, played by Bianca in the movie.
Yeah, she was tagging us everywhere.
Yeah.
And we were like, oh shit, there's a real actress. We need her.
Daddy!
That was great to have both of them in the movie. And when for the first time you see Reggie, we had on our phones a screenshot of the second movie. And we basically told our DP, Robrecht, just mimic exactly
that shot.
The actors, the same thing, the
same
blocking,
angle,
the same
positions.
Thing.
Yeah.
You know, you still need to make an honest woman out of my baby girl there.
Motherfucking Reggie.
Motherfucking Reggie.
Yeah. So what we liked so much about the first movie was also the theme song, you know, the dun 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 dun. We asked our composer Lauren Balfe to make a new version of that. And that's why it's sprinkled everywhere. A little funny thing is that, you know, you have the at the beginning,
yes.
And it's us
our voices.
Yeah, together with the choir, we were part of the choir, right. You know. Yo, so this was a little, you know, Easter egg spiel and all that stuff.
Son.
But I think it's time now to
check the movie.
Yeah, check the movie.
Bad Boys for Life.
Last time.
Heard you guys were making a new Bad Boy film. I think I'd make a great captain.
Go ahead, man.
Mike, Marcus, get in here. I'm tired of screaming at you two. You two clowns nearly destroyed the city of Miami today.
All right, cut. Pretend like
we messed up.
And we messed up. And like
everything's on the line.
Everything's
messing
on the line.
With us.
Yeah.
Isn't that not what I did? That's exactly what I did.
try this a little bit more like, you two clowns damn near destroyed the city of Miami today.
See all that energy?
Must you be so volatile?
Yeah.
Is it possible that I could be aggressive without being loud? You trying to say I always got to be loud? Well, I always got to be loud.
Steve, could you?
No. He likes to be called Stephen A.
Steve is a child's name. Stephen A? Now that's got some heft to it.
Stephen A, could you try this a little bit more like aggressive? You know how you be talking crazy.
I tend to do that sometimes.
Like do that, give us that, we need some of that, man, action.
You two clowns nearly destroyed half the city of Miami today. Did you ever think, maybe going rogue, playing by your own rules, leaving chaos and destruction in your wake is not cute? You crashed cars, motorcycles, helicopters.
Wow. Okay, was that it?
Let me tell you something. I'm a natural captain, you know what I'm saying? Because captains are leaders, and leadership is about confidence, and confidence is expressing a volume of your voice, and nobody is louder than I am.
He's not really good at it.
Yeah, keep working on it.
Bad boys!